because there are people that feel differently about that, and at some point or another, we need to sort of come to some kind of conclusion as to what that, you know, what the reality is and what's just in people's heads. Anyway, you can give us a call.
Thanks, Glenn. Appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. There's more Free Talk Live coming up. You can bring up anything, plus the latest on Ross Ulbricht on the way.
Mom, I can't do my math homework. I just don't get it. I hate math.
I've always tried to be a good mother, but when it came to Jamie's math, I was at a loss. Then a friend told me about Math Made Easy DVDs. Concepts are simplified in an easy way to follow and review, and students can learn at their own pace in the convenience of home. Listen, in the frustration, call Math Made Easy. Call now, 1-800-USA-MATH. That's 1-800-872-6284. Or visit us at mathmadeeasy.com.
Good people need help. The Homeowners Association said we had weeds and fined us $25. We told them they had the wrong house. They said if we didn't pay it, they'd file a lien. Our attorney demanded photographs, witnesses, and told them if they couldn't provide this, they must cease and desist. Issue solved. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case. What good is a Big Berkey water filter?
We get that question a lot here at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. And in a word, the answer is protection. Protection from water main breaks, E. coli contamination, environmental chemical spills, pesticide runoff, chlorine taste and smell, and all forms of fluoride. Plus, Big Berkey water filters are the original gravity water filter system and most trusted on the market for a reason. Tested by multiple independent NSF EPA certified labs, they are the gold standard in water purification. At only 1.7 cents a gallon, a single set of filters can last for 5 to 10 years. That means big savings. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get a Big Berkey today at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. GCN listeners receive 5% off all ceramic filter systems. Visit our website or call 1-877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right, that's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
I'm Kay Swirling from KSCO Radio in Santa Cruz. I'm 93 years old, and I'm a big fan of Alex Jones because he has the courage to speak his mind more than just about anyone I know. Alex is just as bothered as I am about all the advertising you hear for toxic prescription drugs that make you sicker, not healthy. I prefer to give my body all 90 essential nutrients it needs for life to prevent disease, not compound it. My favorite complete supplement is Beyond Tangy Tangerine from Youngevity, which I take every day along with EFA Plus and Beyond OsteoFX. I recommend you go online to InfoWarsTeam.com to purchase these products and make them part of your daily regimen to get healthy and live longer. InfoWarsTeam.com.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
We'll
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you'd like. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about some shocking numbers from the Free Thought Project, and I forget what their source was. But
all over the place.
The police in the United States killing people, and this includes criminals. So this is just all of the killings that they perform while on duty. They're looking at the numbers here and comparing them to other countries, and it's the U.S. is by far the highest in the world. Is that right?
Yes.
More so than China, even by population. Even so, when you compare the fact that China has more people, you know, a ton more people, they have drastically fewer reported police killings.
Okay, so let me retract. This article doesn't address which country police kill more people in.
Okay.
What this article does is it compares the U.S. to other countries. So it's comparing it to Germany, the U.K., Canada.
So in theory,
China.
There could be a country in which the police kill more people than the United States.
Yeah, I have no clue.
They didn't bring it up in this particular report.
Sure. I mean, it would be difficult to get that information from some countries.
Sure, like
you
North
know?
Korea.
Yeah. I mean, you know, where are you going to get that from? Kazakhstan.
Right.
Or whatever. You know, who knows?
So with the available data, it looks
this
like
isn't a ranking, though. This is a comparison. So I don't know the answer. This does not, from what I can tell, do not recall that this addresses who is the cop, the cop civilian killingest country in the world. It doesn't do that.
Yeah.
When
they compare the United States with these other countries, the United States is by far
staggeringly ahead.
Right.
Yeah. When you're talking about a situation that you know, we're talking about what 1,100 people we said in 2014.
Yeah.
Which is dramatically up from 2013 in and of itself. In a period of 1 year, you jumped, you know, 300 or 400 people. And we're talking about a situation where China's talking about, I mean, in the single or double digits, not even into the hundreds, and Canada's very low. And it just stands to reason that I'm going to go out on a limb and say I'm pretty confident that U.S. is number one, not only in per capita incarceration, but also per capita cops killing civilians. I think that's a pretty good bet.
I'd say it's a strong limb to go out on.
Yeah, I would say it's a strong limb, too. What we can see here at this point with looking at the numbers, we haven't gotten to Germany yet. So let me tell you real quick as far as Germany goes here. From 2013 and 2014, German police killed absolutely no one. So when you take the UK, Germany, Canada, China, you're talking about a landmass that's greater. You can everything that you can sort of say, yeah, but all the yeah buts are sort of addressed here. China's more populous. Canada's just as diverse. It's geographically similar. You know, all these things, and we can see that. You know, the numbers don't stack up. The United States is multiples times larger as far as the number of civilians killed by police than these four countries. Is that four? Canada, UK, Germany, and China combined. The population is more about six times what the U.S. is, and they are many times larger than those countries as far as just by killings, not per capita killings, just killings. So the United States outclasses these, these countries in this. USA still number one in killing civilians.
And the other thing, you know, the only and I hate to say anything that might stand up for police here, but I think something in me says that people in the United States are more likely to resist the police than people in China or Germany or France.
Even Canada, because if you say that, for instance, we have a revolutionary spirit, I think that's about the only thing that I could think of.
Yeah.
Like, what's the difference between the U.S. and Canada? Well, the United States seceded from England and Canada didn't. From what I know, and I don't know much about Canadian history, please, all you cakers out there, let me know. But I don't believe there was ever sort of any revolution against U.K. from Canada. I can't think of anything I've ever read. So it's amazing when you read Murray Rothbard's Conceived in Liberty, all of the sort of minor and even semi-major revolutions that occurred up to the Revolutionary War. There were a lot of them, dozens of them in the United States, and I can't think of anything that happened in Canada. There might be some minor stuff, but I'd be interested in hearing about it and maybe even reading about it. But so, yes, I think the U.S. has a sort of a revolutionary spirit in its DNA, if one can have such a thing.
Yeah, people are sort of raised on this idea that you've got some notion of freedom here, whereas in other countries, like, I really don't – that's not even, like, taught in their schools, I don't think. You know, they think that the government is – they are taught their entire lives that the government is there to take care of them. They've got socialized medicine. They've got all these things. I mean, the government is even more entwined in your life in a lot of ways than the government is here in the United States. And we all know how entwined the government is in our daily lives here.
Is that so? Because when you start looking at economic freedoms, Canada, New Zealand, even UK beats out the US as far as economic freedom. UK, I think, is actually just below. Anyway, I mean, you're talking about these English-speaking countries. There's not too many of those, you know, with sort of similar histories. And the U.S. is slipping behind as far as economic freedom goes. Social freedoms, I haven't seen the U.S. even in the top 10 on many of those.
Right. And that may well be the case. I mean, we have some pretty high corporate tax rates. I think the United States has the highest corporate tax rates in the world. But for your average citizen, you know, the socialized medicine in of itself, that the government runs the healthcare system, I think is huge. And that's one of the reasons that I'm so hostile to that idea, is that once people are like going to the government to see a doctor, you know, it's literally the government is healing me. You know what I mean? And it's something that while the United States might fall behind these other countries in terms of economic freedoms as a result of other factors, the medicine thing is second only to education when it comes to government involvement in your life.
I would agree. And it might even be above education. I'm not sure. In the entire history of Iceland, police have only killed one person ever.
That's amazing.
That guy was aiming a shotgun at police officers, by the way. He was a sex offender that was shot and killed. The police came to the funeral and brought flowers. It's an amazing story.
It's incredible.
I mean, it's amazing. Going on, I just want to finish this up real quick. After exhausting all non-lethal methods to detain the armed man barricaded in his house who actually shot two police officers, police were forced to take the 59-year-old man's life. The country of Iceland grieved for weeks after having to resort to violence.
Let's go to Dan. He's in southern Utah. Dan, what are you listening to tonight? How are you listening to Free Talk Live?
On the local 890 radio station, our local talk station.
Where are you in southern Utah?
Down around St. George area.
Oh, very good. Okay, so you're excellent. You're listening to KZNU. Go ahead with your thoughts.
My question is, you know, don't you guys think that probably the U.S. looks so high because the police, more than anywhere else in the world, are probably facing or have the probability of facing armed, armed people, because we have the right to keep and bear arms. Where in these other countries, I think if you disarmed everybody in America, we'd have a lot less police killing people.
Yeah, I mean, I'm all for disarming people. I'm all for disarming people as long as we start with the police.
Doesn't explain instances like the BART cop shooting, where they had a guy handcuffed on the ground, surrounded by police, and a cop shoots the guy in the back.
That's anecdotal, though.
I think that's real, but it was a negligent discharge, and that was
what they claimed.
Right? Yeah, if I shot a man who was handcuffed in front of me, I'd say that I meant to pull my taser too. I mean, I don't know what else you would say. I don't know what happened there, but when you look at it, it's just amazing. I think that, you know, I think you deserve, if you or I accidentally shot a man in the back, but when we meant to go for a taser, but we shot him instead, I think we'd get more than 13 months in prison, don't you?
I imagine you're probably right about that.
That's what really bothers me about those situations is that we're talking about a different class of people here.
Thanks, Dan, for your call tonight. I do appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. More about the police killings. We'll continue that discussion, plus the latest from the Ross Ulbricht trial happening in Manhattan. That's still to come on Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges. This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Lose the winter blues and warm up with hot flooring deals from Lumber Liquidators. Thinking about hardwood? Consider bamboo. We've got the number one brand, and we'll help you get it for less. Like Strand Bamboo. It's twice as hard as oak, and for a limited time, it's only $1.99. Why pay as much as $4.99 for bamboo at other stores? We've got deals on over 70 styles from an incredible $1.79. Plus, pre-finished hardwood, laminate, and more for less than half what you'll pay somewhere else. And 18-month special financing. Now is the time to warm up your home with new floors. So visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates, 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary, not a solicitation for legal services.
Yeah?
Did you want to see me, sir?
Well, I did, but now that I do, I'm not so sure.
Sir?
Johnson, I got a mission for you that could change your life.
Oh, good, sir.
It involves traveling halfway around the world without so much as half a clue of where you're going or what you're going to do when you get there.
Situation normal, sir?
Uh-huh. Right, I'll be leading this mission, Johnson, so I'll be telling you what to do.
You, sir?
That's right, Johnson, and I say first things first.
Oh, good plan, sir.
And what I say is first is food. Always remember that, Johnson. Food is a big deal.
Sir, my brother-in-law can get us a really good deal on some surplus MREs.
Johnson, if you've got half a brain and that empty head of yours, you'll call the freeze-dry guy like I did. That food is better for you, it rehydrates faster, and it's good, Johnson. And it keeps for up to 30 years.
Will we be gone that long, sir?
I hope not. Now get your supplies organized and meet me down to the pier at dawn on Sunday. We sail at sunrise.
Yes, sir.
This adventure is brought to you by the freeze-dry guy. Call 866-404-3663 or visit
loveandguy.com.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now. No other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. You take control here toll free at 855-450-FREE. Still to come, the latest on the Russ Ulbricht trial. He is facing the rest of his life probably in prison for ostensibly running the Silk Road. We know he created the Silk Road, but did he run it the entire time? That's what the federal government is going to be alleging, and the testimony continued today. We'll give you the latest on that. Plus, we're talking about the cops right now. Of course, you can bring up anything at 855-450-FREE.
At coffee.freetalklive.com, you can go there and you can get a free sign up to get a free pound of coffee. It's a subscription program. You can cancel it at any time, but you can get that free pound and you can get up out of there if that's what you want to do. Or you can stay on the program, like so many have, and get delicious, shade-grown, 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica bean coffee delivered right to your doorstep or wherever it is you get your mail delivered. And you can customize it as far as how often you get it delivered, how much you get delivered, you know, those kind of things. And it's really convenient because it just sort of takes care of that whole coffee problem. You upgrade your coffee drinking experience dramatically by upgrading the price a bit. It's certainly not, you know, it's not as inexpensive as the coffee you get in stores. But the coffee you get in stores is often stale, been lying around. Many times there's mold ground right into it because, you know, who's checking these things? It's coffee.freetalklive.com. But what they do is they give us back some of the profits in order to give microloans out through kiva.org. And we've helped people around the world with a variety of situations in order to better their living experience. It's coffee.freetalklive.com.
All right, so where were we in this story from the Free Thought Project?
Well, we were reading just sort of statistics about other places around the world that and what, you know, police using deadly force against their citizens there and looking at the dramatic differences in places like Iceland, Germany, UK, Canada, and even China. Caller called in. Was his name Russ? I'm sorry, I shouldn't just guess at his name.
I did not keep track.
Yeah. And he said, well, what the difference with Canada is basically they're disarmed. Now, only up till recently did they change the gun laws in Canada. And let's not forget that it's the longest undisputed border in the world exists between the United States and Canada. Okay. There, if you wanted to get guns into Canada, you can get guns into Canada.
Yeah, and Canada might not issue a whole lot of concealed carry permits, but I should point out that they don't have an outright ban on guns in Canada, right?
No, like that's true.
Like Justin Bork, the guy who shot at police, made some headlines last year or earlier this year, I forget. Last year. It's January of 2015. So, you know, he had legal guns. His guns were perfectly fine until he took them out of the house and openly carried them. So, I mean, there are certainly weapons in Canada. I do believe that, you know, most of Europe
hunting
has
rifles.
Been far more... had their weapons far more restricted.
There's
than,
nothing
than
to
Canada.
Hunt in Europe, right? Like, there's plenty to hunt in Canada.
Right.
So, I mean, this is part of the issue. Essentially, all the wildlife in Europe has been anything bigger than a dog has been killed off. You know, they, to the point that they have in England, they wring their hands over the hunting of foxes, right? I don't know much about fox hunting in Europe, but I know that many in Canada consider it a barbaric practice, and. So, you know, here in New Hampshire, they're debating about bringing back trapping bobcats. So, I mean, that's an entirely, it's just a different place. Going on, to better understand the multidimensional answer to the question as to why it is that the U.S. is killing many more people than other first world countries, we can start by looking at the prison population of the U.S. American prisons are almost 25% of all people imprisoned in the world. I would say that this has to do with not just the war on drugs, but it's mission creep. Governments love to grow.
Yeah.
And the government, if it was profitable for the government to kill you, they'd do that. But it's not in the U.S. What's profitable to them is for them to imprison you, so they need to put prison guards on you and they need to maintain, because it costs $60,000 a year or whatever per prisoner to imprison somebody. That's why they do it. It's essentially yet another big government program.
I don't know if profitable is the right word for it. I mean, yes, to a certain extent with government agencies, expenditure equals revenue. But I don't think profitable is the right word. Government is spending money to do these things, not receiving money.
But they receive the money because they spend it. I mean, I don't know what else to say. The profit isn't the right term because they're not a business.
Right.
But, I mean, they're not.
It's 100% loss as a business model. It's the entire point of it is to lose money, but you get to extract money from people through force, and you don't have to worry about being a profitable entity.
Every manager managers that don't have to pay for their employees' paychecks like small business people do. But every manager wants to have more people to manage. It makes them, you know, look more important.
And the pleasure of money is in the spending, not in the earning.
Yes. So what you're talking about is essentially just managers growing their purview in order, you know, then more managers popping up. And then by the managers, I mean officers in prisons and that sort of thing, and judges and prosecutors. And then they want more minions, and then the minions show up, and the minions want promotions. And then this is a essentially supply side economics writ government, you know, and it's fascinating to look at as long as you don't have to pay for it. But that's what this is. That, I mean, you know, the government makes money. Is that a better term? Not profitable, but makes money.
It receives an excuse to spend, I would say. I mean, okay. They make money through taxation, right? Like, if the government wanted to, like, have more money, they could tax and not spend, right? Like, if the government wanted to, like, build up some big fat bank account somewhere, they could just be like, hey, we're going to tax you.
They sure don't do that crap,
do
they?
And not spend the money. But, of course, they're pretty much in perpetual shortages of cash because they spend more than they tax, and then they tax to get more and still manage to come up short somehow.
The federal government, I mean, I can remember when we were doing the show 10 years ago, within the last 10 years, looking at the federal debt, and it was $3 trillion. I'm like, this is outrageous. Six times that number.
It has exceeded 18 trillion of a few days ago. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, and the number just keeps on going, and like nothing's going to happen.
Not
Americans
counting
go on and on.
Unfunded liabilities. No. That's hundreds of trillions of dollars.
Yeah, what are they counting when they don't count unfunded liabilities? What the hell are they counting? An unfunded liability, by the way, is something like your mortgage payments that aren't yet due.
Right.
So, I mean, you've got a mortgage payment, say, $1,000 every month that's due, but you have that due for the next 27 years. Those $1,000 payments out 27 years, those are unfunded liabilities.
Right. So the government counts as, quote, debt, the money that it has actually borrowed and must pay back in terms of a loan, right?
Mm-hmm.
But when it says, hey, citizen, we're going to extract money from you for your entire life and then pay for your entire retirement, well, this is not counted as a debt, right? They don't think that they actually owe you that money. That's a gift that they're going to give you later on.
Yeah, I guess you're right as far as that goes. Going on, the U.S. houses 2.3 million inmates, while China, a country with four times the population of the U.S., they just said it was 4.5, so yep, is a distant second with 1.6 million prisoners. The war on drugs, coupled with the military-industrial state created by the U.S. playing police around the world, has created a deadly combination. A constant pursuit of new weaponry by the military has paved the way for the hand-me-down cycle of military gear to police departments. The idea that if the U.S. wanted its police to act like drug warriors, it should equip them like warriors, which it has, to the tune of around $4.3 billion in equipment, according to a report by the American Civil Liberties Union. What are we calling the militarization of police has already taken place on a large scale.
It's been going on for decades, since the creation of the SWAT team, basically.
Yeah, I'd say that's about the time frame. Mm-hmm. It makes sense when you've got this extra military gear just lying around. Let's give it to somebody. Who would we give it to? Well, the police makes sense. They can, you know, sometimes people shoot at them. Let's give them things that are bulletproof.
People make a big deal about the militarization of police forces. And granted, like, I'm not a big fan of it because I don't like what the police are doing, because I don't think that they're justified in using any level of force to do the vast majority of the things that they do. If they were going out and, you know, enforcing things that needed to be enforced, if they were justified in their threats of violence in the first place, I don't really care about what kind of weaponry they're using in the course of it. I want the good guy to be better armed than the bad guy.
Same here. Absolutely.
The problem is that the police are not the good guys.
That is a problem.
In certain circumstances. Another problem is just sort of that whole military gung-ho hoo-ah thing that they get going. I mean, if the police have that whole hoorah thing going, then who is the enemy? And that's very difficult to figure out. I think that that needs to be undermined. And what my recommendation for that is the color pink. I think that all of the—I'm not kidding you when I tell you—I think all of the military-grade stuff that is considered surplus and given to police should be painted either light blue.
What about pink uniforms?
They should give these guys on the SWAT team
tutus.
They can have the regular tan Andy Griffith uniforms when they work the job, but when they do the SWAT team stuff, everything needs to be powder blue or pink or light green, frosty mini green.
855, 450 free. More Free Talk Live coming up. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now. No other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com, and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective. America Tonight with Kate Delaney plays here. GCN.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Wednesday, January 21st, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,295, silver at $18.02, and Bitcoin is trading around $212.85. Today's precious metal price is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. With civil unrest occurring all across the country, being food secure has never been more important. Visit eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, Ross Ulbricht trial, week 2, is underway in New York. With the San Francisco man facing a laundry list of charges in connection with the operation of the now-defunct Silk Road online marketplace. A key to Tuesday's proceedings was the ruling by Judge Catherine Forrest that speculative statements as to the identity behind Dread Pirate Roberts, the alias of Silk Road's operator, will be prohibited, and only questions regarding physical evidence and provable facts related to the identity will be allowed in the record. The ruling came in response to a motion by the prosecution related to last week's defense cross-examination of the DHS special agent, who revealed that there was a time that it was suspected that the CEO of Mt. Gox, and not Ulbricht, was the Silk Road mastermind. Last week, over 50,000 protesters marched in Germany against the Transatlantic Trade and Investment Partnership and genetically modified organisms and factory farming practices. Over 120 different organizations came together to stand against the TTIP and the possible introduction of GMOs and other American farming practices in their country. Activists also condemn farming practices popular in the U.S., including the heavy use of pesticides and antibiotic injections in farm animals. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. The Liberty Beat is also brought to you by My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at mymagicmud.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, January 21st, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. Only days after accusing the president of Argentina of covering up a bombing, a prominent Argentine prosecutor has been found dead in what is being called a suicide. Alberto Nisman was the lead investigator into the 1994 car bomb that killed 85 people at the AMIA Jewish Center in 1984. He was scheduled to present his findings to Congress this week. Nisman's ex-wife said she did not believe he killed himself. Following the announcement of Nisman's death, a crowd of around 2,000 people took to the streets, screaming, "Murderer!" as they surrounded the presidential palace. Whistleblower Edward Snowden recently told a Russian news outlet that he never uses an iPhone because of special software that collects information from users. Snowden's lawyer says his client prefers a simple phone and avoids Apple products. His lawyer stated that the iPhone has software which can activate itself without the owner having to even press a button and easily gather information about the user. These claims back up similar accusations previously made by another hacker and forensics researcher. A detainee being held in Guantanamo Bay Military Prison has released a book titled Guantanamo Diary, detailing his experience being subjected to rendition, torture, and interrogation. The Liberty Beat is brought to you in part by WatchMyBit.com, the first ever micropayment-based video service. If you're a content creator, visit WatchMyBit.com to learn how you can use Bitcoin to generate revenue for your art. That's WatchMyBit.com. Support for the Liberty Beat also comes from the Conscious Resistance Network, featuring videos, news reports, and articles, all from a spiritual anarchist perspective. Experience the Conscious Resistance at theconsciousresistance.com. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
For health and vitality for you, your family, and friends, get the Healthy Start Pack from Longevity, as recommended by registered pharmacist Ben Fuchs.
If you're a junk food junkie, getting on the
Bisco's breakthrough T.C. McCrispy's line of crackers arrives today. Available in regular, garden ranch, and zesty cheddar, the new crackers will flood consumers' bodies with fat, salt, and starch to produce a pleasing sensation of warmth and nourishment, momentarily freeing them from a relentless, crushing sense of profound grief. Mel Krychek is Nabisco's Director of Corporate Communications.
Our tasty new snack cracker will, if only for a few lovely moments, significantly lessen the hideously bleak and empty torment of modern life that festers in every solitary soul.
Nabisco expects most despair-riddled consumers to eat an entire box in one sitting. Doyle Redlin for The Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. You dial in here toll-free and bring up whatever you want. 855-450-FREE. Coming up, the latest on the Silk Road trial, which is also known as the trial of Ross Ulbricht. He is facing pretty much the rest of his life in prison for running the most, infamous of online black markets to ever have graced the earth. It's an amazing thing, the Silk Road. We can talk more about it and what all that means here in a little bit. And we'll give you the latest from the trial today that continued in Manhattan. But first, to Dave in Poughkeepsie, New York. Dave, you're on with Ian, Chris, and Mark on Free Talk Live.
Hi, guys. How you doing?
Dave, I'm glad you asked, Dave. Because, you know, I was hoping you could give me some advice about some troubles that I'm having.
Last night, you guys had a caller. I think his name is Mabel or Fable, whatever. He said that I was annoying.
Dave, why don't you care? Annoying. Why don't you care about Chris? I mean, he's asking, he's reaching out to you.
Yeah,
he's
you just asked me how I'm doing, and here I am trying to tell you, and you're just like, let me go into my point. I mean, right. Did you just call here because you wanted to like make your voice heard or something?
Last night, there was a caller, and they were saying that I was annoying.
Callous.
I am not annoying. If people didn't piss me off, I would not be so angry.
Well, it sounds like there's some people who are annoying you, and now you're calling them annoying. They're pissing you off. So, I mean, isn't this pots and kettles and whatnot?
I just don't like people pissing me off, because if nobody pisses me off...
I'd love it when people piss me off. I mean, this is what I wake up for in the morning.
But Dave, I mean, aren't you in control of your own feelings? Can't you just decide to not be so easily upset?
Yes, I am. But like, if people didn't piss me off, I would be a whole much more nicer person.
But didn't you ever get taught when you were a kid, sticks and stones that may break my bones, but words will never hurt me? I mean, you're supposed to let the critique just kind of, or the attacks or whatever you want to call it, these people that are trying to upset you, just let the insults roll off of you and just don't let them affect
you at
all.
Actually, it sticks and stones that breaks my bones, but whips and chains frighten me.
So,
too much information, Dave.
So, you should put that into the next video you make on YouTube, looking for women. I think that they're going to really like that one, Dave. After you say no fat chicks for the third time in the video, you throw in the whips and chains thing, and I'm sure it's going to be
clincher.
That's going to be your next viral video that brings in all the AdSense revenue that pulls you out of whatever it's living. Situation is that you're in.
You said you wanted some advice. Go ahead.
No, I don't really want your advice.
Yeah, thanks for the call, sarcastic. Dave. Good luck. 855-450-FREE. I mean, Dave never has listened to our advice. I mean, we've honestly tried to help the guy. We've tried to, you know, let him know that, hey, if you are encountering people who are upset, you know, you're getting into arguments with online in certain places, don't go to those places. But the problem with Dave is whichever place he goes to, he starts the problems. He's the one who comes in with the nasty attitude and is rude and calls people names.
We know this because we had the BBS.
Right, because he comes on our forum and does that exact same thing. And
to some extent, Dave is the id in this situation, right?
What does that mean?
Well, you know, the Jung and Freud posited that there's the ego, the superego, and the id, right? And the id's this very basic, childlike thing inside of you, this part of your personality. And we all have to deal, if you're online, and especially on someplace like Facebook, you have found an idiot. They're out there, lots of them. They say things.
Certainly no shortage of them.
And they don't know what they're talking about.
Yeah, they constantly comment on freekeen.com.
Their opinions stink, and they're not backed up with facts. And they oftentimes, when you do talk to them, you try to give them a little, you know, you pop in with a sentence or two, bestowing upon them some wisdom, and the idiots don't like it. You'd think that they would be delighted. Yeah, they'd be delighted to hear from you. No,
you're ugly.
I'm really talking about the majority of people on Facebook in these forums. I'm not talking about just somebody who says things like that. Because most people, nobody can agree with you 100% of the time. And somebody who disagrees with you is an idiot, right?
Nope.
Yeah, but I'm talking about the average
you're
person
the one who
who's
looks
listening
down
to me.
On people like that. I don't do that.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying. But the average person kind of has this philosophy, right? Like they're right, the other people are wrong. And this is pretty common human behavior.
Okay.
And
well, if people didn't think they were right, they'd probably change what they were doing.
I'm
right?
not talking to them because I've tried talking to you for years and it doesn't work. So I'm talking to the people on the radio. And what the best thing to do is just kind of let it go.
There's people, a song about that.
Yeah, just let it go. You're not going to fix this person. There's a person on the internet who's wrong. You're not going to fix them.
Yes.
I have had one time, I believe, that I have been convinced away from an opinion. I'm not talking about convinced.
On the internet?
Yes.
Okay. This was memorable then, huh?
Especially a forum-like situation. It was on Facebook. But
what was it?
It was about the use of him and her regarding people who wish to have sex changes. So what I decided was, you know, there's a definition for him. There's a definition for her. We're going to use those things. This person, it was Charles Johnson. We've interviewed him on the air. He basically said, look, you can be the king of your words. Your words can be the king of you. And I thought that was a pretty powerful thing that he'd said, and he backed it up with a little bit of stuff. And so I decided, that's interesting. Maybe I've changed my opinion. But it rarely happens that you change your mind. So if you think about how often you've had your mind changed on Facebook, and then you should see, and I'm or message forums or whatever. Dave in Poughkeepsie is all about this place called, Hudson Valley's Craigslist Rants and Raves.
That's one of the places he haunts.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and
you want to find Dave, that's where you go.
Whatever it is, your preference is, dummies, they don't get fixed by you writing stuff down generally. If you want to write essays for free for stupid people, you can do that. The internet's a free place. Go right ahead. But I like to get, if I'm going to spend my time on something, I like to get paid for it, especially on something that looks remarkably like schoolwork. I'm not going to do it. I've just decided no more, or at least less of that behavior.
Let's go to Eric. He's in Valdosta, Georgia. Eric, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Chris Cantwell, and Mark.
Hi. I wanted to talk about an article that Cantwell wrote last week, the conspiraphobia, was Reason versus Ron Paul.
Right on, yeah. There is an article.
Sum this up?
The Ron Paul Institute had republished an article by Paul Craig Roberts hinting at, possibly this Charlie Hebdo shooting in Paris was a false flag terrorist attack in order to, grab more civil liberties away from the people of government, power grab. And, certainly enough, immediately after this thing happened, there were raids all across Europe. Dozens of people were arrested, and then the various European governments began looking for what were essentially mirrors of the USA Patriot Act in their own countries that they were trying to seize power over, something that was like a dozen people dead, which don't get me wrong, it's a terrible thing that happened.
Sure.
But it doesn't seem like something, a mass shooting like that did not seem to warrant the response that it got. So there, Paul Craig Roberts had hinted that maybe this is some kind of false flag terrorist attack. Reason Magazine, The Weekly Standard, a lot of other people went after the Ron Paul Institute and called them conspiracy nuts for even allowing such a thing to be published under their name.
Isn't Paul Craig Roberts former aide to Reagan?
Reagan, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I think he was a Treasury Secretary or something to that effect. I mean, he had some pretty serious titles.
Eric, before we get to your thoughts, Chris, what was the thrust of your article about this?
Well, my case was basically, look, I'm not convinced that the Charlie Hebdo shooting was a false flag, but I'm also not convinced that it wasn't. I don't like that there's this immediate thrust, especially amongst like the Cato/Reason wing of this movement, to go out and condemn anybody who proposes some alternative theory to the official government story. Mm-hmm. If a bunch of people wind up dead and the government's making a power grab out of it, hey, you know what? It's not exactly unheard of for these people to lie. So, sure. Governments are basically in the full-time business of theft and murder and death. So why would anybody be surprised that they killed a bunch of people and lied about it is beyond my comprehension. So I don't know why all these people were attacking Ron Paul and the Ron Paul Institute and Paul Craig Roberts himself just for sort of looking at the situation from another angle.
Eric, hold your thoughts. We're going to get to you, give you plenty of time to share the reason you called about that article here in a moment. And your calls and thoughts are welcome. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. The latest from the Silk Road trial of Ross Ulbricht happening in New York City. That is still to come here on Free Talk Live. 855-450-FREE. You can take control of the airwaves. More coming up.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia with his wife, kids, and grandkids all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription Cancel at any time. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The show is Free Talk Live. You can take control of the airwaves here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Still to come, the latest from the Silk Road trial. Ross Ulbricht facing the rest of his life in prison for running the most infamous underground black market that we've ever seen. And it's, of course, to me, I think a heroic thing that he did. They have admitted that he did create the Silk Road, that he was the original programmer behind the site. But he says that he didn't continue to operate the Silk Road, that it was handed off at after just a few months to a different operator. And we'll find out what was revealed in the courtroom today, or alleged, I guess, in the courtroom today, here in a little bit from Wired.com. But your calls come first. We got Eric on the line in Georgia. Now, Eric, you were calling regarding a Chris Cantwell article, and Chris is in the studio with us here tonight, at ChristopherCantwell.com, regarding the shootings, the Charlie Hebdo shootings, wherein I guess there was an article that Ron Paul's Institute or something had posted suggesting that it might have been a false flag. And Chris, you were kind of taking some of the libertarian, the Reason.com and some of these other mainstream groups within the libertarian movement to task on their critique of Ron Paul.
Yeah, so I think it was, I want to say his name was Matt Welch at Reason Magazine.
Sure. Sounds right.
Okay.
Right.
And he had basically just gone and called it an implausibly conspiratorial rant, senseless dot connecting exercise, this sort of thing, and didn't bother to like take apart any of the points that PCR had made.
That's Paul Craig Paul Roberts. Paul Craig was Roberts. The author of the-
And so I'm like, look, if you've got a problem with, you know, a conspiracy theory, then why don't you go out and point out the facts? I really get annoyed when people just dismiss something as a conspiracy theory and say that as a result, there's just no further examination of it necessary. Because basically, like I said before we came back, if governments are in the full-time business of murder and lying to people, why would anybody be surprised if they killed a bunch of people and lied about it? So I don't like that they
incompetent, right? Like, I mean, it's not wrong.
And I've said that in the article too. That, yeah, like, look, I don't think that governments are really capable of, you know, sort of centrally planning every bad thing that happens.
So
in
you
the
weren't
world.
Taking a side on the article. You were just saying, hey, why shouldn't they be able to ask questions?
Right. So my premise was basically just that, like, look, I'm not here to stand up for Paul Craig Roberts, and if I was, I'd be going and digging through his fact-checking exercise, right? And if I were going to attack him, then I would do the same thing. What I'm here to talk to you about is conspiracy theories in general, that I think that they're good things for the greater libertarian movement. But folks that think they're going to, I don't know, get Rand Paul elected and restore the bloody republic are just so concerned about being labeled as conspiracy kooks, and they just won't even look.
Eric, what do you think? What were you calling in reference to specifically?
Well, yeah, I was mainly. There's an article that usually is passed around by those quote unquote conspiraphobics, as Cam will call them, or the quote unquote skeptical libertarians. That is usually used as justifying for, you know, just I guess for it's just usually more than anything just shuts conspiracy theories up. And it's by Steve Horowitz. You may have seen it, but the conspiracy theory socialism, which essentially the argument is that it hurts the libertarian movement because we do invite people to make the argument that we kind of essentially make the argument that central planning is possible, and that we leave the door open that say, well, if we just get the right people in charge. Oh. That we can make everything wonderful.
So the idea is that conspiracy theories themselves give the government credit for the ability to organize, and so therefore that conspiracy theories themselves are sort of socialistic in nature.
Yeah, if you really, I think if you take like maybe, and if anyone takes like maybe 2 minutes to actually just critical thinking, it's easily refutable.
Yeah, so I've seen that argument made before. I'm not familiar with the Horowitz article that you're talking about, because I would never read something that Horowitz wrote. but I know the idea behind it, and I sort of alluded to it in my article that, like, look, I know that there's some conspiracy oriented people, the you know, David Icke's and Alex Joneses of the world and whatnot, who will go and basically blame every bad thing in the world that happens on some kind of government conspiracy theory, and they are, in a lot of cases, just implausibly ridiculous dot connecting exercises, mm-hmm. right? But at the same time, the idea to just, you know, it's equally as ridiculous to dismiss any possibility that the government would kill a bunch of people and lie about it. So, I mean, a situation where a couple of guys basically walk into a newspaper and just shoot a bunch of people, run away, and then get killed, and now there's nobody left to speak of to tell you the story of this. Look, I don't think that that's beyond the reach of a government. Like, can a government go and kill a bunch of people and then murder all the witnesses? I don't think that that's on par with claiming that they can run the medical system or centrally plan the global economy. They're certainly more than capable of running into a building and murdering a bunch of strangers. This is what they do for a living.
Yeah, and I'd say that is one thing they would say it's not hard to go on a limb to say that they are a little proficient in centrally planning things that would benefit for them. I mean, as you were kind of, as you guys were talking about earlier about the
police industrial complex.
Yeah, I think there. I think it's certainly true. I mean, given enough budget and time, and people with the desire to see something accomplished, they will get something done, right? Like, you know, the NSA has been monitoring a bunch of phone calls, and they do have some fairly technically adept people working there.
Yeah, and a few years ago, if you said the government is monitoring all of our communications, people would call you a conspiracy nut and completely dismiss you. And then all of a sudden, they get the documents from the NSA, and all of a sudden, now the story is believable.
But on the other hand, the more people that have to be involved in the conspiracy for it to be true,
right,
the more ridiculous it becomes.
How many
right?
people had to be involved with PRISM?
Well, I don't
a lot of people.
The NSA.
Yeah, I mean, for any of these things that the government does, I mean, now now we found out that the DEA was monitoring your telephone communications. They kept this secret for how many years?
But even if it was a conspiracy, you know, that some sort of plot to have the government agents go in and shoot up this magazine. The idea that all of the reactions from the other governments around Europe were somehow tied into that, then it becomes more implausible, right? Because then you're dealing with more agents in other places mm-hmm. who don't even necessarily work for the same governments. And that, you know, it gets a little bit ridiculous.
But doesn't it seem bizarre what went on over there afterwards? I mean, you're talking about millions of people marching in the streets because 12 people got shot to death in Paris, right?
Well,
and then world leaders from across the world are going to France and saying, "We stand with you." I'm like, this is the biggest overreaction since 9/11. Your people are out of your minds.
Eric, thanks for your call, Eric.
I don't consider this to be implausible at all. I mean, the fact is that people hate the idea that they're responsible for their actions. And in Europe has been giving out free money in the form of welfare and the dole to immigrants for decades. And what that has caused is a lack of assimilation. And now they're reaping the whirlwind and they hate it. You know, people hate the whole financial crisis that came around a couple of years ago in Europe. They hated the idea that it was their spending, that completely irresponsible spending was something that they had to pay the piper for. That makes them very angry. They want to kill the politicians for that crap.
All right, let's come back with more here. We can talk more about conspiracies.
Let's do that.
I'm not a huge fan of the conspiracy movement. That's not to say I don't believe in conspiracy, but it's not something that, you know, I would want to turn this show into or lead with as an idea. 855-450-FREE. There's more coming up. Free Talk Live.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Are you hungry for delicious, nutritious, rich, and satisfying home-cooked meals? Discover the Vita Clay 4-in-1 Smart Organic Cooker. Unglazed Zeesha Clay, an ancient secret that makes this fast multi-cooker so special. Infusing your food with incredible flavors, perfect texture, vitamins, and minerals for your good health. It's a slow cooker, rice cooker, a steamer, plus a yogurt maker. Go to VitaClayChef.com and enter promo code RADIO20 for 20% off at checkout. That's VitaClayChef.com.
Fossilized evidence reveals the Spazosaurus was the largest doofus ever to roam the Earth, and a new tandem mobility scooter is released. This is the Onion Week in Review, dammit, and we're going to need you to demonstrate a little decorum. Got it? This week, economists confirmed that the booming tear gas industry continues to lead the world's economic recovery. Financial experts confirmed that the growing demand for tear gas in countries like Turkey, Brazil, and Greece has increased over 20% annually over the past few years, and is anticipated to continue playing a major role in the world economy.
The market for tear gas just keeps sustaining itself and growing. We can only hope that more people demand tear gas in the coming months, and the recovery will be here sooner than we thought.
In other news, a community is devastated by the sight of an old man struggling up some steps. A stack of unused CDRs turns 5 years old, and this shitty zoo is really promoting the hell out of their new fruit bat. Your diligence and patience have been noted. Prove yourself further at theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
I'm Mark Stevens of the No Stay Project, and are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, You're only helping the government. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, use it, spread it. So get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls toll-free about whatever you would like to discuss. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Still to come, the latest on the Silk Road trial of Ross Ulbricht. We'll get to that. Of course, your calls about anything go here. And also, you can join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm.
It's really unavoidable to have to fill out those little pieces of paper that the government wants in order to get the things you need in life. For instance, you know, if you've got a will, all your stuff gets generally distributed the way you want it to. If you don't have a will, the government decides after years how your stuff's going to get distributed. So that's just one example of the many things that they've got at LegalZoom.com, including divorce papers, living trusts, business annual reports, pet protection, powers of attorney, prenups, name changes, copyrights, deed transfers, leases. Whatever it is that you need, likely it's over there at LegalZoom.com, and likely it is significantly less costly than, say, going to an attorney. You can go to LegalZoom.com, use coupon code FTL when you're checking out in order to save $10 on your order. It's LegalZoom.com, coupon code FTL is in Free Talk Live.
Okay, so we were talking about conspiracies and, you know, the idea that maybe the Charlie Hebdo shootings were somehow a government plot. I don't necessarily subscribe to that, but I don't subscribe to anything. I don't know what the truth is. I don't have, you know, the facts of the case. I'm not there. I, you know, have not deeply investigated it. So I certainly don't take any kind of side on this. And the same thing with 9/11. You know, I don't know what actually happened. I know that the conspiracy theorists have a variety of different conspiracies that go all the way to include alien spacecraft.
Right.
And so I think that we have to be cautious about getting off into the realm of speculation, because, you know, ultimately, I think that the conspiracy movement is not a good thing for the liberty movement in general. I think that there's an argument that is solid that some people in the liberty movement found the liberty movement by finding people like Alex Jones and, you know, and somehow then found Free Talk Live or Chris Cantwell or whoever after that. And then they, you know, have come to the realm of sanity. But my concern is the conspiracy movement leads people down a very dark path that is very paranoid and very personally dangerous to one someone's mental well-being. And I think we should be very, very cautious about it.
I think it's a thing worthy of being cautious about. But at the same time, look, if I want people to turn against the institution of the state. So if they're turning against the institution of the state because they reject the use of initiatory force and fraud, that's obviously the most optimal outcome, right? Mm-hmm. If they're turning against the state because they believe that it murdered 3,000 of its own citizens to predicate a war based on lies, well, this is like a close second or third, right? I want people
that's
to...
That's an ends justifies the means argument. If that didn't occur, if the United States government didn't on 9/11, and I don't know, murder 3,000 of its own citizens, then... I don't want people to think that because that's not the truth.
Well, but generally, they're not going to turn against this. People aren't going to turn against the state as an idea because they believe that the state committed some sort of violence at some point, whether it's 9/11 or killing, you know, John F. Kennedy, Kent State, or, you know, whatever, which, you know, whatever the state violence was, whether proven or unproven. It's very rare that people coming to the conclusion that, hey, the government did that, makes them turn completely anti-state. There usually has to be a little bit more intellectual play to make that
right. No doubt about that. I mean, I was at the 9/11 Truth Rally in New York City in, I think, 2013, and like they had liberals up there talking about how the government brought down the Twin Towers, and that's why we have to raise taxes. I mean, really is some very ridiculous stuff that goes on out there.
Or the idea that, well, the state's fine if we could only just get Ron Paul elected or some other perfect man.
And people are, you know, there are plenty of people out there that are sort of philosophical, that this idea of conspiracy theories, whether it's 9/11 or HARP or whatever it is, really turns them off. So how many people have been turned away from the liberty movement because it's associated with the conspiracy theory movement?
Well,
I don't know the answer to that.
You can't really get too worried about that, right? Because
I don't worry about it.
We'll also turn people away by talking bad about the police. Too.
Right.
You know, how many people do we lose because of that?
Well, right. I don't worry about it. But when one says that we embrace conspiracy theories because it brings people to the ideas of liberty, you need to look on the other side of that.
Fair enough.
Unseen, that is how many people are driven away.
Yeah.
If we're looking at an ends justifies the means scenario, we don't know what the ends are. We have no clue. And that's not a fair way to judge it. What's fair is let's talk about the morality, the logic of
and
the
let's
scenario.
Talk about facts. Let's talk about what's actually happening. Let's talk about the police violence that we discussed in the first hour. Those are facts. Those are hard facts. We don't need to speculate about, you know, what temperature steel can melt at before, you know, and bring in a bunch of experts. You know, it's just right out there. We don't have to speculate about the Silk Road trial. This is happening in front of us, and we can talk about what it means and why the state's a terrible idea. Luke is with us listening in Charleston, West Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live. Luke.
Well, if I were a social justice warrior, I would accuse all you guys of having beauty privilege.
beauty privilege?
Not Ian and Cantwell, you wouldn't.
well, maybe, but to add on to what you just got done talking about, a lot of people in rural areas, especially where I live, they're anti-government, anti-state because it's like racial racist reasons, like because whatever group is in power pulling the strings, or they're bringing in this group to destabilize or what have you. A lot of people do that, and that's the big mess I've seen. But that kind of ties into what I was going to call in, how I came to liberty, because I remember in 2003, I watched on CNN, a live footage of them, dropping the bombs on Baghdad, and, I was, 14 at the time. I knew right then, this is all just, it's not worth it. It's all big, we aren't there for any reason, man. It's that, and, gold and silver, I was always told how important those are. And I went to the flea market the other day. I was talking to this guy who had a survival store, which really, it just seemed like a camping store. But he had some books, he had a Rothbard book. I forgot which one. He had a couple other ones. I'm talking to the guy, and he knew nothing about Bitcoin. I asked him if he took Bitcoin, because I bought a couple things off of him. And he says, no, I wish I did. And he didn't understand how easy it is to take it. I mean, he read about it, but he didn't understand the process of it. And, I mean, you'll find people who are just ready to embrace things like Bitcoin or cryptography or, anything with a liberty sort of leaning to it, if you just go out and talk to them, just find where they are and talk to them. There's a lot of things we also like to talk about, whether it be guns or gun rights or free speech or what have you. People in those groups, if you just give them the rest of the picture, they will just it'll all click for them.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right.
I don't know that if you give them the rest of the picture that it will just click, but you know, hopefully it does. But I mean, you even mentioned, you know, people having, you know, racial concerns and you know, turning against the state for that. I'm fine with that. Like, if you hate the government because you fear that it's run by Jews and you're not a big fan of Jewish people, then look, I really would rather you be a philosophically sound libertarian and reject the concepts of initiatory forces being a solution to problems. But you know,
I don't think we need them, Cantwell.
Yeah, I'm not
speaking as, by the way, an ethnic Jew. I really am not interested in that in the liberty movement. I would like to be able to walk out of wherever it is that I am live.
But I'm not even talking about the movement itself. I'm talking about trying to solve a problem, and the problem is people's belief in this system, right? The people's belief in this institution. If somebody just doesn't like the government because they hate Jews, well, then look, that's not, you know, you're not a libertarian, right? That's not like a good, if you're perfectly fine with initiatory force, but you're kind of upset right. that the government is helping out black people, well, then, you know, that's not a libertarian thing. You're not part of the liberty movement, but you're certainly taking away from the legitimacy of the institution the more people who feel negatively about it.
Luke, well, any other thoughts? Well, I'm talking about those people. I don't necessarily mean, you know, people who are happen to be, you know, anarchist kind of types who just don't like whatever race. I'm talking people who, like, if we just get rid of these racial problems, we can then restore the republic types. That's what I'm talking about. And then that's what I'm talking about where it gets muddy, because the whole restore the republic thing, that's not going to work.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. The restore the republic is it's not going to happen.
I'll take it over what the heck we got today.
Government's not going to be restoring itself in any manner, shape, or form to a smaller level in Washington, D.C. It's just going to keep getting bigger until it crashes and burns. Thanks, Luke, for your call tonight. And yeah, I don't care about racists. They can go and believe whatever they want. I don't want to associate with them. More on the way here, 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
And now from the Cato Institute, the Cato Constitution Minute. The Constitution was not America's first governing document. The first was the Articles of Confederation, created in 1775, under which the existing states grouped themselves as a union. Under the Articles, votes by the 13 states had to be unanimous, and what was enacted didn't have the force of law. It was merely a suggestion to the state. The Constitution's supporters, the Federalists, argued that the Articles were weak, because the nation couldn't make good on its debts or prevent squabbles among states. Be careful what you wish for, their opponents, the Anti-Federalists, warned. A more powerful federal government could dominate the states and people. The Anti-Federalists lost that battle and the new Constitution was ratified, but it is in large part thanks to them that we have a Bill of Rights, the first 10 amendments to the Constitution adopted to address their concerns. To learn more, visit the Cato Institute online at cato.org.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now, no other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
More Free Talk Live now. You can dial in toll free at 855-450-FREE. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Cantwell.
And Mark.
Check out Chris's website. It's ChristopherCantwell.com. There's all kinds of writings up there from Chris. You're posting at least a couple times a week, plus the videos now that you're cranking out. Chris, you're pretty busy over there.
Yeah, I've been taking clips from Free Talk Live on the nights that I'm on and putting them up. So if you want to get some highlights from the show, you can go to ChristopherCantwell.com/FTL. Make sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel because not all of them go on ChristopherCantwell.com. I've got this system where it emails users every time I make a post, so I try not to make too many, maybe
Makes
one
sense.
Or two a day. But I've been writing pretty much every day lately. We've
Excellent.
Been doing some garbage podcast at least once a week, sometimes twice. We actually did a sort of like a Mystery Science Theater 3000 last night with the State of the Union address. Was a blast. So definitely check that out. Subscribe to the email list because I can't rely on Facebook to keep me in touch with you. The social justice warriors keep reporting my posts.
ChristopherCantwell.com. Go and check it out. Also, we've got our weekly digest at freetalklive.com that I believe we're going to begin featuring at least one Christopher Cantwell video that you've been taking from Free Talk Live. So one of your clips will make it into our weekly digest email that goes out to like 2,000 plus recipients.
Excellent.
So, yeah.
That's great.
So that's coming soon. But if you aren't yet on our email list, you can go to freetalklive.com and look over on the left-hand side, and you'll find the email sign-up box over there. That, again, freetalklive.com. Let's go to Chris Kringle in California. You're on Free Talk Live. Chris.
Okay, this is my Pete Wilson, but that's my new alias, Chris Kringle. Huh?
So his last name is Wilson Pete in California.
That's what he claims.
Okay.
Yes.
That's my new alias now. From now on, instead of calling him as Pete, it's going to be Chris Kringle. Okay, well, look, anyway, about the Sovereign Citizens Movement, I have a question. You say that it's not a big threat and they don't take it seriously and it's whatever. Well, why does the Southern Poverty Law Center and the Treasury and all these other organizations talk about it being a threat?
Because the Southern Poverty Law Center is a bunch of race-pimp liberal lunatics. That's why.
I know. I agree, but what I'm saying is, if it wasn't a big deal, and the thing they're talking about, the all caps and stuff, if that wasn't true, then why are they afraid of that? I mean,
why are they afraid of the all caps stuff? I mean,
they're afraid of it because, you know, most people go into a courtroom thinking, oh, the facts of the case matter. These people go in there and basically go into probate court with the mindset that your birth certificate's a trust in all caps and.
It's a bunch of nonsense, by the way, the all caps.
Right, but the government in my town doesn't use all caps.
Oh, it's the truth. Why do the cops make your ticket, or what's the
What's the truth?
What's the truth? Did you hear what I said? The government in my town doesn't use all caps.
They don't use, well, that's referring to a question from that person, but
I'm sorry, we couldn't make out what you were saying.
They're still robbing me.
Background noise. So you're saying you believe the conspiracy theory, the sovereign citizen conspiracy theory, that you're not the person that is shown on your driver's license because that is a person whose name is written in all capital letters, and therefore that's an indicator that it's actually a corporation and not a human being. Is that your belief system?
Of course. It can be proven. U.S. printing style manual. No. Identifies a corporation as anything with all capital letters.
That's an interesting claim, Pete, but it's nonsense because, as Mark just pointed out to you, that you just handily dismissed, that the government in his town does not use all capital letters when they address people. And I have seen inconsistencies in this. So sometimes governments in New Hampshire, you know, do, and sometimes those same governments do not.
The greater majority, they do, in all caps. If it's
Well, then you haven't proven anything.
It has to be consistent, otherwise it doesn't prove anything. Because if the all caps refers to your, you know, corporate personhood, and then they don't spell it in all caps, they're not referring to your corporate personhood.
Well, you know what? Maybe there's different stuff, but across
the
greater
majority.
So,
Pete, what have you all managed to do with this information? Since you believe it's so true, you must have applied it in your life and have managed to extract yourself from all these government control grids and agreements that have been put into place over the all caps.
I sincerely hope that basically Pete in California, or Chris Kringle, as he now wants to call himself for whatever lunatic reason he wants to say that, I sincerely hope that he just ceases to obey any sort of government authority. And
just yell to the cop, I'm not the person on this card.
Right.
This isn't me. This is a corporation, officer. You can't arrest me.
Yeah, the next time that you go get her, you know, arrested for harassing somebody on the street for screaming about Jesus in their face,
right,
you just
tell a street preacher, right?
Right. You just go tell the cop. You'd be like, hey, I don't answer to you. And let me know how that works out for you over there in California, Pete.
How's that been going, Pete? How have you applied this in your life?
Let me tell you something. You know, this whole thing that it doesn't work, absolutely it works. And the second thing is this, that you know what?
Just because you make the claim doesn't make it true. I asked you specifically, how have you applied it in your life? If it works, then give me an example of how it's worked for you.
I haven't had to use it yet, but I got my...
You don't know what you're talking about then. Goodbye, Pete. Yep. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. What's he waiting for? I mean, if this is such a great idea, you know, this idea that you're somehow not the person on the driver's license and that it's actually a corporation and that the government can't act on you, they can only act on corporations. I've read all the stuff about this.
Me too, yeah.
I actually tried to implement something like this in the past because it does have the ring of at least some modicum of truth. It's certainly true that every time you look at a corporation, it is written in all caps in most any instance I've ever seen.
Right.
Which is, you know, it's a weird thing. And then, of course, you know, they extrapolate from that. Oh, well, then my license says I'm in all caps there, so this must be a corporation and da-da-da-da-da. Well, what do you do with that? You can try to tell the judge in the courtroom that, oh, no, sir, that's not me. I know you're calling for Pete. You must be calling for the corporate Pete, and I'm sorry. But
I'm not that straw man, and you try to walk into a courtroom with that. You're going to be lucky not to get held in contempt, but go ahead, give it a shot. Come to New Hampshire
don't come to New Hampshire.
Well,
we don't want Pete.
Maybe we don't want Pete. The next time we're thinking about taking one of Pete's calls, why don't we just go burn ourselves with cigarettes instead?
So I'm looking at my driver's license here, and not only is my name in all caps, but so is the street
address.
The street address.
It's a corporate street.
Is the street? So are we not talking about the pavement on the ground? We're talking about the corporate entity known as the street. I mean, this is how far do we go with this?
Well, apparently Pete hasn't gone anywhere with it because, you know, when I asked him specifically what experience he has, he dodged and dodged and then finally admitted, like almost every single person who calls with these conspiracies, that they've never actually tried it.
So
you try it. You take the risk, Mark. You take the risk, Chris and Ian. I'm just going to sit back here and tell you that it works.
Right. I've been listening to podcasts from creditors in commerce, and they tell me that I don't need a driver's license and that every time I write a check that the United States federal government will reimburse me, and then I'm going to file a 1099 OID.
Don't forget, you can get out of your mortgage, too. Just make sure you write the right UCC
code
on it.
You don't have to pay bills, right? You just have the IRS pay the bills for you because your signature is creating the money in the system and yada, yada, yada. Yeah, I listen to all this nonsense, too, and I'm lucky I didn't spend the rest of my life in prison for trying to go along with it.
Yep, it's true. And it's true that some people will use these ideas to essentially try to kind of defraud the system. And look, I'm no fan of the system. Don't get me wrong.
Right.
I don't like fiat money. And I understand where the claims come from. Like, oh, well, it's no big deal if you use this secret code to pay off your mortgage because the money didn't really exist in the first place. That's true. Like, it's certainly true that the money system is a debt-based system, and every dollar that's in existence is actually evidence of debt, and that if the federal debt is ever paid off, that all the dollars would have to disappear from the system. So it's based on some modicum of truth, but then to use that and extrapolate from that, oh, well, since the money's not real, it doesn't matter if I just don't pay this mortgage or this car loan, and I'll just write UCC 207-159 or whatever on there, and then I'll get out of all my obligations because I shouldn't be obligated because it's not real money in the first place.
Well, let's
and then
not
you
forget-
get a charge with fraud.
Well, I don't know if that's okay. So what's going to happen likely is if you decide not to pay your mortgage, say, and you're in a homestead exemption state like Florida or something like that. You know, people do this all the time. That you can file bankruptcy every 10 years. They just pile up some debt and then they slough it off. It's done. You know, I had to file bankruptcy at one point because of a failed business. I know how that if I wanted to defraud the system, I could make that happen, and I'm aware of how to do it. So that's what's going to end up happening if you try these things, is you're just going to end up filing bankruptcy.
Well, I think you'll end up getting charged with fraud.
If you depending try, on okay. what you do, yeah, you could get yourself in a lot of trouble. I mean, you know, one of the things that I listened to was they talked all about this 1099 OID, original issue discount, and they're like, look, since the money is being created by your signature, then you're entitled to the money, right? And then mm-hmm. You file this form with the IRS, and people have actually filed these forms where they get hundreds of thousands of dollars deposited into their bank accounts by the IRS. And they're like, oh my God, all of my financial problems have been solved. And then a few weeks or a few months down the line, agents show up at their house and they're like, hey, lunatic, you just defrauded the United States federal government. You're going to prison.
There's some really dangerous ideas out there, Mark, that are being pushed by some of these conspiracy.
Sure.
I don't know what the best thing to call it, because we have courtroom conspiracies. This is just like legal conspiracies, I guess. And yeah, beware. 855-450-FREE. You take control. More coming up. Free Talk Live.
Safety, safety, safety. I'm saying it three times. Studies show you need to hear something three times to remember it. So remember, safety, safety, safety is important to me, me, me. That's why I love Grainger. Grainger has the products to help keep our facilities safe and people safer. Say it with me, kid. Safety, safety, safety from Grainger, Grainger, Grainger. When you think safety, think Grainger. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgrainger.com/safety or stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges. Yeah!
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Tuesday, January 20th, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,276. Silver at $17.69. And Bitcoin is trading around $210. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Your job, your home, your car, your money. All of these provide you with a sense of security. But what about your family security? What have you done to prepare if all of these things were suddenly gone? eFoods Direct has the food security. Direct is food security. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 and mention LibertyBeat for 50% off their food preparation planning packs. In the news, jury selection begins today for the trial of James Holmes. He's the former neuroscience graduate student accused of killing 12 people during a midnight showing of The Dark Knight Rises in July 2012. Reuters reports nearly 9,000 potential jurors are expected to be screened. The 27-year-old Holmes earlier pled not guilty by reason of insanity. He faces the death penalty. His legal team maintains he was suffering from a psychotic episode at the time of the shooting. A new report has found that at least 50 U.S. law enforcement agencies are using radar devices that can see through walls into the homes of unsuspecting Americans. The tools have been in use since at least 2012 and have cost $180,000, according to federal contract records. A federal appeals judge in Denver recently stated the government's warrantless use of such a powerful tool to search inside homes poses grave Fourth Amendment questions. The ACLU has labeled President Obama's recent executive order on police militarization as the equivalent of putting a Band-Aid on a war wound. The ACLU's Washington Legislative Office Director, Laura Murphy, stated that the president should consider a moratorium on the Department of Defense's 1033 program until further study and controls are put in place. The 1033 program supplies local police departments and agencies with surplus military equipment and weaponry. Kenyan police fired tear gas at students in Nairobi who were protesting what they say is a theft of their playground. After a two-week teacher strike, the students found the playground fenced off and sold to a private developer. This broadcast of the Liberty Beat is sponsored by WatchMyBit.com, the first-ever micropayment-based video service. If you're a content creator, visit WatchMyBit.com to learn how you can use Bitcoin to generate revenue for your art. That's WatchMyBit.com. Support also comes from The Corey Moore Show, comedy-minded and liberty-focused. Live each Friday night at 10 o'clock Eastern. The Corey Moore Show at CoreyMooreShow.com. This is The Liberty Beat for Tuesday, January 20th, 2015. Check out the website at TheLibertyBeat.com. The director of the controversial film Grey State has been found dead, along with his wife and daughter, in what is being called an apparent murder-suicide. 29-year-old writer, film producer, and Army veteran David Crowley, his 28-year-old wife, Komel, and their 5-year-old daughter, Rainey, were found dead inside their California home on Saturday. The deaths are currently under investigation. Crowley had been working on the film Grey State, which was a fictional account of a brutal police state and martial law being imposed by a tyrannical government. Seeing everyone connected to the internet is the goal of Google. And that's the apparent reason why the tech company is expected to invest nearly $1 billion in Space Exploration Corporation. The Wall Street Journal, citing people familiar with the talks, reports that Google is interested in Elon Musk's SpaceX because the company plans to use satellites to spread internet service to all corners of the world. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your messenger product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more details, go online to thelibertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, January 20th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now, no other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
Free Talk Live, you can bring up anything. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that are waiting for you on the site. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. With you tonight, you've got Ian
Cantwell
and Mark.
We're going to talk about the Silk Road, the latest on the Ross Ulbricht trial from the courtroom in Manhattan today. That's still to come. But first, Greg is in Brooklyn. Greg, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight, Greg?
All's well.
Hey, I wanted to talk about net neutrality and actually my perspective on things. I hope it's okay.
Go right ahead.
Different... Cool. So my perspective on sort of politics is, in general, I don't see states, cities, and corporations as like special things. I don't think the government is special. I think everything is organizations. So the way that I would look at, you know, if I lived in a co-op building and it had a management team and they had like a no pets policy, to me that's just a smaller version of an organization that needs to be run somehow, and they appoint people to run it so that other members can go on with their lives. So to me, the questions are more about scale and how in touch the management team is with the people and so forth. So when it comes to net neutrality, you know, and I see that like a city has put together, dug up the streets and put together infrastructure for the phone lines, and so they have it, and Google is offering to work with that, versus like Time Warner, which was incentivized by the U.S. federal government. But to me, Time Warner is an organization. The city I live in is also an organization. Like, I want them to compete. And to me, it's not like, oh, the city's evil because it has a government and it uses violence. Like, Time Warner will also use violence. It just outsources it. So that's how I think about it.
When has Time Warner used violence? Just curious.
Anytime they ever filed a lawsuit.
Sure.
Anytime they ever called the police. I mean, Time Warner uses violence. Everybody uses violence in some way or another.
I get what you're saying there.
We're protecting our property with threats of force.
They're using the government to do their bidding for them, is what you're saying. They're using an agency of coercive force, an agency with a monopoly on coercive force, which would be the government.
I mean, look, people are going to use force in society. They either go through the government to do it or they do it themselves. I mean, if there's no government in place, then when somebody has some monetary dispute, then they're going to find some other way to extract those funds. And so I don't disagree with his premise. I think we've talked to Greg before, and you know, he brings up this point that, yeah, I mean, there's force being used regardless, right? So look, I don't disagree with his premise, but of course the where he goes wrong with it is basically that the government goes and de facto takes over a continent and says, I own all of the people living within this continent, and they're completely out of touch with us, and they use violence to do all sorts of horrible, horrific things, and this is not anything even resembling any type of market-based dispute resolution.
Well, there I would have to correct you a little bit about my views. I don't think that the United States government owns all the land in the United States. I think that the United States is a federation of states, and those states are organizations themselves, which have their own governments, and those organizations own the land because people decided to manage the land this way.
No. We did not decide to manage the land this way. Dead guys, hundreds of years ago, wrote a document without the consent of anybody who was being governed by the document, and now hundreds of years later, we're still referring to this document as the reason that these people in Washington, D.C. get to bully me around. Right, and this is a religious notion, right? We're praising ancient documents written by dead Christians. It doesn't make any sense.
Well, look, IBM's bylaws were written by dead people too, but IBM has to have some way to run itself, right?
Right, but I don't have to work for IBM. I don't have to be at IBM. I have to be at my house, right? I have to own property in a given geographic area, and go search Google for the Jones Plantation, because that's the next thing you're going to tell me is that I can always leave. But if the Jones, go watch the Jones Plantation. It's a Larkin Rose video where he goes and he points out that, you know, there's a, he makes this analogy that there's a slave plantation, and Mr. Jones right. owns a whole bunch of slaves, and the slaves are kind of like getting sick of being slaves, not working very hard. So Mr. Jones goes out and hires a consultant. The consultant comes over and he says, guess what, slaves? You're free now. You can go if you want, but if you leave, the other plantations will enslave you. So you're free to be here. And, you know, and they go into this whole thing of like, you get to keep some portion of your labor. But of course, you know, we've got to pay for these expenses. So you've got to give, you know, the majority of it to Mr. Jones. And it's the exact same thing as the slavery that they were in before. At the end of the day, he's just calling them free. It's the same thing. The government is not the co-op at the condo. It's a completely different concept that it's forced people into.
Well, listen, I'm not talking about sharecropping here. I'm saying that nobody owes you, to have an organization ready for you to run according to your terms. Like, whatever building you move into...
They owe me non-aggression. They owe me to not destroy my life from thousands of miles away.
It's a human, courtesy. It's a courtesy that all humans should extend to one another, and that is to not hit each other and to not kill each other and stab each other. But the government guys don't do that. They won't extend that courtesy to us. They'll only not do those things as long as you jump through all of the hoops that they put up for you.
You realize you guys are not arguing to Greg's point. First off, poor Greg, you have thrown the red meat out to the tigers again, and instead of talking about net neutrality, you let him
get... I don't know what Greg's point is. He's just been rambling on about different organizations.
What his point is eventually going to be is that the government's going to save us by taking over the internet. And I don't even understand. I want to ask you an honest question, Greg, and I'm sorry to distract from your point. I really want to ask you an honest question because this fascinates
sure.
me.
Go ahead.
Why do you listen to Free Talk Live?
Well, I like to call into a radio show to test my ideas if there's an obvious flaw in them. You guys are the most incentivized to point it out, and I really take it seriously what you say.
I'm glad. Thank you very much. I just wanted to, you know, because it seems to me like I don't understand how somebody who believes that a government is capable or could be capable of doing anything positive could tolerate 15 minutes of this program. It just doesn't make any sense to me. This is like,
well,
to me, it's like if I was trying to like listen to Alan Combs or something like that, I'd blow my brains out.
I listen to the Alan Combs show.
It's actually decent. He's a decent host.
He's not bad. He's not a bad guy. Listen, I listen to Republicans, liberals, libertarians. I listen to Rothbard. I listen to Milton Friedman. I respect a lot. So yeah, I listen to all kinds of viewpoints. But I have a question also. See, the reason that I take on this viewpoint is because it lets me make statements about the world and reason about the world in ways that are practical for me. So if I see an organization called a city, and my city is pretty effective at XYZ, you know, it already has the infrastructure, I don't think like, oh, it's immoral, the city is way less moral than Time Warner. I look at it like, okay, you know, what system would give me the best outcomes? And morality, in my opinion, doesn't always enter into the equation, because I can't apply morality to complex systems. Like, is copyright moral or immoral? It's going to be, you can't run a society based on morality if people disagree and object what morality is. So I use outcomes, and basically I pick the organization I want to live in, because at the end of the day, any building I move into is going to have a policy I disagree with somewhere, and they're going to use guns, as you say, at the end of the day, to extract rent and everything else.
Yeah, I think that that's a powerful point, Greg, and I think that you know, it really defeats a lot of the arguments. However, it doesn't defeat this one, and that's, and I've put positive before, is if you have either an option to allow someone to disassociate from your organization, and in this case the government, or you don't. And if that person can't disassociate, that person's a slave. And if that person can disassociate, then your organization, the government, will never stay together. Because here's the reason. If I decide, you know, I'm on the outskirts of town, I make a great deal of money, my town is taxing me more than I wish to tax, I wish to dissociate from my town, and if my state's going to do it, then I wish to dissociate from my state, and if the federal government's going to do it, I wish to dissociate from the federal government. If I can create my own little country where I don't have to pay any taxes, then, and I'm a wealthy person, I'm going to do that. If I'm a poor person, I'm going to be like, please, I need all the extra free money I can get. So what you'll end up having is there's a lot of poor people banding together demanding free stuff, and a lot of rich people saying, go to hell.
I'm going to give Greg a chance to respond to that here in a moment. Your calls and thoughts are also welcome. 855-450-FREE-PLUS, the latest on the Ross Ulbricht trial happening in New York City. More on the way. 855-450-FREE. You take control of the airwaves here on Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Oh, is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission, Wage and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service,
look,
and the Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare, and, of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business, but free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. A public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live. You dial toll-free here and bring up anything at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. Our Skype username is LRN.FM. And we can hook you up with some precious metals like gold and silver.
Yeah, you can go get them at gold.freetalklive.com. The rates on precious metals here recently have been quite low, surprisingly low. And it seems like it's time to get some. Load up. Go to gold.freetalklive.com. You'll get great prices, great service there. gold.freetalklive.com. We've teamed up with Midas Resources. I've been doing business with them for years, many years, and it's always been a good experience. Certainly, whenever you're dealing with customers, there will be an issue. And, you know, here and there over the years, I think there's been two instances where we've, you know, somebody's complained to us and we told Midas and they got right on it. So I think you're going to be happy with the service over there at gold.freetalklive.com.
Well, you don't stay in business for 20-something years. I don't know how long. I know they've been around since GCN's been around at the very least, and they came around in the 1990s. So you don't stay in business for decades by getting it wrong, that's for sure. So go check them out, gold.freetalklive.com. As we continue here, we've got Greg on the line in New York, and Greg has called in with his theory that governments are nothing ultimately different from condominium associations, which, of course, breaks down right at the very get-go, considering that you actually have to consent to join a condominium association. And nobody I know has consented to be governed by these governments, by these states.
Well, yeah, before I answer, I just want to ask you guys a favor. I'm sorry, it's a pet peeve of mine. Just I heard on the radio sometimes, I don't know who it is, it says, like, go to hell. And I just, it really, like, it's like nails on a chalkboard for me, because it's more than just an expression.
You heard
I'm a
what?
Little bit religious. Somebody, I forgot who.
Yeah, it was me, Mark. I said what I said is the rich people, you know, are going to tell the poor people in a society where people can disassociate themselves at will, they're going to tell them to go to hell.
And that's offensive too.
Right. Well, I mean, that is, as long as it's not directed towards me or someone, I guess it's not offensive to me.
Did it sound like I said that? Because I apologize if that's how it made you feel. That was not my intention.
Did not tell that to Greg.
I wasn't telling Greg to go to hell. What I was doing was putting this imaginary situation where rich people can essentially disassociate themselves from governments and taxes at will, and they're going to tell those governments and those taxes to go to hell.
Right. Okay, well, let me just answer. I want to make it clear, because I've been calling in, as you know, from time to time. I just really want to make it clear. A government, to me, is a government of an organization. So, for example, the government of New York State, the organization is New York State. So, in other words, the government of New York State does not own anything. They manage the organization the same way it is a European Union. You know, management team does all sorts of, there's different bureaucrats.
So if New York State doesn't own things, then who does own the property in the land
controlled
as New York State?
New York State. It's the organization is New York State.
Okay.
And they own everything in their geographic landmass, by your viewpoint, correct?
Well, so let's go back to your question. You're saying, in effect, let me find, you know, a building where I can start my own sort of, let me move to a place and start my own thing, and I'm rich and I can afford it. I think you're taking a lot of things for granted. I'll illustrate. Let's say you're rich in bitcoins, okay? You have a lot of bitcoin.
Okay.
And then you say, you know what? I want to opt out of the bitcoin economy. I want to start my own cryptocurrency somewhere else that's not governed by anything. I'm going to start my own thing. Say, okay, cool. The thing is, no one will accept you need network effect. If you let me give one more example.
Sure, there's hundreds of these altcoins out there who are a bunch of guys who've tried to start their own Bitcoin competitor, and they've pretty much gone nowhere.
Yeah, I've got a bunch of Dogecoin. It's not worth anything.
Yeah. What's the point you're getting at there?
Exactly. So I'll illustrate with one more point, and I'll make the point. Here's another example. If you are on Facebook and you say, I don't like the way Facebook is running things, the privacy settings, I can't set them, they're constantly reverting to this. I just don't like the way they're running things and the ads. It's terrible. I'm going to start my own social network. I'm going to get this open source thing that was put together by five people. I'm going to run it. You know, first of all, the software is going to be worse. The hosting is going to be worse. But also, the network effect will not be there. All your friends will be on Facebook. So just keep that in mind when you say, I want to opt out of my city or my town or something. Even if you could do that, eventually it'll just grow into another Facebook or another big organization.
It'll I would agree. Let's this imaginary situation, since we're going with it, let's say that I acquire 200 acres here in nearby to Keene, and I decide I want to secede. And, you know, since we have a voluntary situation here and governments aren't really agencies of force and violence, they say, well, you own it. I guess you're going to have to go, and you just pay us taxes for services, so we're going to have to let you go, but we're not going to give you any services. No public school for the kid that you have that you don't send to public school anyway, and we're not going to maintain your roads, which we don't maintain anyway, and we're not going to, you know, come and send our fire department to your house, and, you know, we're not going to do these things for you. So I say, awesome. I'm going to set up my solar power panels. I am going to have satellite internet, and I am going to be off the grid. And I'm going to invite other people who want to live like me. And I can assure you that there are a bunch of people in this area that would say, yes, I will buy one acre, 10 acres, whatever acre from you. And we can live in sort of this, your little country, Markistan, that you've just created.
Right.
And I ask you, can I, in your world, where you know, governments are much far more peaceful organizations, in your world, can I disassociate?
Well, governments are not organizations. I want to make that clear again. They're management teams of organizations.
Okay.
But you're saying you live in, let's take it smaller. Let's say you live in a city, okay, a city state. Now you tell the city, I want this block to belong entirely to me. I have what's called fee simple property, which means I have sovereignty over it, the same way the English crown has sovereignty over some areas where they can kill people on it, and there's no jurisdiction. You know, you can do whatever you want. I don't think that's possible in a city, but you can certainly. There are places on the high seas. There are places on the earth that are still not administered by anyone, and no group has decided to, as you say, have a monopoly of force there.
Yep.
So yeah, you could totally go there, but you can't do it like in your own, you know, city, because that would disrupt the way the city is being run. Why would it let anybody to just opt out but still live
right.
there?
Well, right, like they won't let you opt out because right. they own you, and what? They will use violence against you if you don't do what they want you to do. I mean, that's why they're different from the
average organization. But that's really what it comes down to, Greg, is either you're a slave or you can opt out. It's one of those two things. So the city, the town, the municipality in which I live says, nope, that property's ours, and you're going to pay us taxes on it until you die, and then the next person who gets it is going to pay taxes on it, because in reality, that's just rent on that property.
Yeah.
And when you work, we're going to take a percentage of your labor because we own your body and soul. As a matter of fact, we're going to spend ad finitum. We're going to go $18 trillion in debt. We're not just going to spend your money for the rest of your life. We're going to spend your progeny's money before they're even alive.
Greg, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
Those are your choices. Your choices are either you're owned, body and land by the government, or you're free to disassociate, and you're not free to disassociate. So that's the reality of the situation.
Yeah,
I think Greg makes some great points when he talks about homeowners associations and that we all use violence in order to protect our property and all those things. He makes great points.
Sure, there's a difference between defensive force and initiating aggression, which is what the government does. More coming up. This is Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE, the Silk Road Trial on the way.
Genesis is defined as an origin, creation, or the beginning. Genesis Communications Network began with the mission of providing you with the kind of compelling content you're listening to now. And at GCNlive.com, you'll find a free archive of our nation's history, narrated by GCN hosts. Explore, share, and pass down to future generations. GCN is the future of talk radio, but we should always strive to learn from our past. Together, we are GCNlive.com. GCN.
Mom, I can't do my math homework. I just don't get it. I hate math.
I've always tried to be a good mother, but when it came to Jamie's math, I was at a loss. Then a friend told me about Math Made Easy DVDs. Concepts are simplified in an easy way to follow and review, and students can learn at their own pace in the convenience of home. Listen, in the frustration, call Math Made Easy. Call now, 1-800-USA-MATH. That's 1-800-872-6284. Or visit us at mathmadeeasy.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that are waiting for you there on the site. Once again, freetalklive.com. Check out Chris's website, christophercantwell.com. And also, Free Talk Live is brought to you by Victimless Crime Spree. You go to victimlesscrimespree.com and you can watch Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. You know Derek J. If you've listened to the show before, you've heard him on Monday nights. Well, he and I put together a movie along with Bo Davis, the editor, and it's a great 90-minute-long documentary. But if you're short on time, you can watch the hour-long version as well, all for free, over at victimlesscrimespree.com. Speaking of victimless crimes, the Silk Road case. Ross Ulbricht continued in court today in Manhattan. This is the most important case of the decade, likely, and maybe even, you know, our lifetimes. It's pretty important what's happening there. Ross Ulbricht is accused of being the administrator of the Silk Road, a.k.a. Dread Pirate Roberts. The Silk Road is an underground, or was an underground, marketplace that sold primarily drugs, but some other stuff like fake IDs and stuff like that. And they took him down in 2013 toward the, I guess it was like October of 2013. They arrested Ross. They shut the site down. He's been waiting in prison ever since for his trial, which began last week. And I'm going to give you an update here. But does that kind of summarize? Did I miss something? Just kind of a brief summary of Ross Ulbricht there?
I think that brings him up to speed for whatever we got coming up.
Yeah, so it's the prosecution. They're still going. They've only been through one of their witnesses, I think, at this point, and that's that takes us to this. Oh, by the way, one other thing you should know is that the very first day in the trial, the attorney for Ross Ulbricht did admit that Ross created the site. So we know that much is the case. What they're saying is that he wasn't the administrator of the site the whole time, that he let the reins go to another person a few months in and then somehow was brought back in, like snookered into coming back to administer the site later, and then ultimately was framed for running the site.
And there's some speculation that Mr. Karpeles, I believe his name is the CEO of Mt. Gox, had been... the
had been Dread Pirate Roberts.
Been Dread Pirate Roberts.
But yesterday, the judge... told the jury to disregard most of the testimony about Karpeles.
Right, I had read that too. And it's so funny to me how hard they try to keep information out of the hands of jurors.
Oh, yeah.
It's so crazy that they're just like, well, no, you can't introduce this, you can't introduce that. Like, hey, jurors, go in that room while we conspire behind your backs, and then we'll bring you back in so that you can only receive the information that the government wants you to have. And this is how you're going to decide if this man should spend the rest of his life in prison for web hosting.
Silk Road, this is Andy Greenberg over at Wired.com. For most of more than 2.5 or more for more than 2.5 years online was an unprecedented online narcotics emporium. But according to a journal found on the laptop, allegedly, of its alleged creator, Ross Ulbricht, Ulbricht wanted it to be even more a brand that extended from communications tools to banking. In Ulbricht's trial Wednesday, prosecutor Timothy Howard read aloud from a journal that was allegedly found on the defendant's Samsung 700Z laptop, which was seized at the time of his arrest in San Francisco library in October of 2013. The journal, which goes back at least as far as 2010, seems to provide the most detailed look yet at Ulbricht's plans for his libertarian contraband market. And the journal reveals that before his arrest, Ulbricht had allegedly planned to create a Silk Road brand chat client software, currency exchange, and more. The young Texan had allegedly planned to expand the Silk Road into a brand, quote, that people can come to trust and rely on, unquote. According to a 2011 passage from the journal, quote, Silk Road chat, Silk Road exchange, Silk Road credit union, Silk Road market, Silk Road everything, unquote. Ulbricht's journal credits.
Merchandising.
Ulbricht's journal credits that ambition.
Is that Spaceballs?
Yeah.
Is that
right?
In part to a mentor who he calls Variety Jones. He has helped me see the larger vision, Ulbricht writes. That roadmap for Silk Road was never detailed in public by the Dread Pirate Roberts, the pseudonymous figure who ran the market and often authored posts on the Silk Road user forums describing the market in revolutionary libertarian terms. But when I interviewed Roberts in 2013, he did allude to plans for a next phase of the site, including the sale of consumer electronics and possibly reintroducing the sale of firearms, which had been banned from the site. And as Ulbricht seems to write in his journal, secure communication tools. At the time of our interview, that last topic had become particularly relevant thanks to the first published leaks from NSA contractor Edward Snowden. Roberts told me at the time, quote, one other big development I'd like to mention that is coming, whether we do it or not, is communications privacy. If it wasn't clear before, this is a quote I believe from either Silk Road or the Journal. Quote, if it wasn't clear before that the state is your enemy, it should be now that the biggest covert intelligence agency and the biggest government on the planet has been stealing nearly everyone's private communications. We have the technology right now to make this impossible for them. End-to-end encryption and Tor need to become standard for communications globally.
just as SSL has. You must demand it from your communications providers. Again, if Silk Road can play a role in this transition, I'm more than happy to provide. That ends the quote. Ulbricht's journal, which the prosecution has only begun to dig into Ulbricht's trial, appears to provide a goldmine of evidence for his guilt. Prosecutor Howard read aloud a passage from 2010 that details growing the first 10 kilos of psychedelic mushrooms in a cabin in Bastrop, Texas, to serve as the Silk Road's first products, launching the site on the Anything Goes web host Freedom Hosting and making the site's first transactions. Ulbricht writes of his first sale, quote, "I was so excited, I didn't know what to do with myself," unquote.
Wait a second. So Ross Ulbricht is in a journal saying that he grew 10 kilos of mushrooms to start the Silk Road?
That's correct. That's the allegation. If you believe this journal was actually written by Ross Ulbricht, that they allegedly found on his laptop.
You know, but they're admitting to starting the website. The website, I presume that there's some evidence that the website was started off with a bunch of mushrooms being sold on it. Now there's a journal allegedly written by him. This guy, I don't know what the strategy is here for this defense. He's confessed to, he's going to spend the rest of his life in prison.
I agree. Well, I don't know for the rest of his life, but if they can avoid the kingpin charge, maybe he'll avoid the rest of his life in prison. And I think that's probably what they're going for, is to try to not, you know, get him convicted for the kingpin charge. But yeah, you're right.
I guess that's the idea here. But I mean, you know, you have a continuing criminal enterprise that goes on for a period of years. Even if he ducked out for a few years and then came back to it, you know, this is still
There's some things that people can learn, right? I mean, even if Ross Ulbricht goes to jail, something to take away from this, don't keep a journal of your exploits. If you're doing things that are illegal, just keep it in your head, okay? Don't write this stuff down. It's a terrible idea.
Well, writing it down isn't a great idea, especially if you're doing your criminal exploits, and perhaps you should use some code or something like that. But If you've got to write things down for sort of record keeping,
keep it
purposes.
In a TrueCrypt container.
Well, right, record keeping is one thing, but to keep a journal seems completely unnecessary.
If you're his problem was living in the United States,
and it would have been a fascinating story. Like, you know, I would love to see this journal get, you know, published long after Ross Ulbricht had died, and you know, have that information out there to, you know, have it told how the Silk Road was started. I think it would have been a fascinating story and perhaps a New York Times bestseller.
That's a good point.
But it's just a terrible tragedy that this is sitting there on his computer when he gets popped.
The journal goes on to describe recruiting the site's first staffers, described by the names SYG, Digital Alchemy, and Utah, as well as meeting his soon-to-be advisor, Variety Jones. Later, Ulbricht even describes partly confessing his Silk Road secret to someone named Jessica. Quote, I felt compelled to reveal myself to her. It was terrible, he writes. I told her I have secrets. I'm so stupid. Everyone knows I work on a Bitcoin exchange, Ulbricht adds. Everyone knows too much. Damn it. Unquote. Ulbricht's journal will likely serve as the centerpiece for the evidence the prosecution has assembled to prove the narcotics conspiracy, money laundering, counterfeiting, and other charges he faces. Aside from the journal, FBI computer scientist Thomas Kiernan on Wednesday showed pictures he took of Ulbricht's seized computer, showing that he was logged into Silk Road's administrator panel called Mastermind at the time of his arrest. Prosecutor Howard went on to lay out a maelstrom of evidence pulled from Ulbricht's laptop, including a private PGP private key that had been used for signing messages as the Dread Pirate Roberts, HTML code that matched the code on the Silk Road website, and an application for economic citizenship in the Caribbean island of Dominica that had been filled out with Ulbricht's full details. So maybe he was trying to leave.
Wasn't trying hard enough.
Didn't get there fast enough. 855-450-FREE. We'll talk more about the Silk Road case in moments. This is Free Talk Live.
Lose the winter blues and warm up with hot flooring deals from Lumber Liquidators. Thinking about hardwood? Consider bamboo. We've got the number one brand, and we'll help you get it for less, like Strand Bamboo. It's twice as hard as oak, and for a limited time, it's only $1.99. Why pay as much as $4.99 for bamboo at other stores? We've got deals on over 70 styles from an incredible $1.79, plus pre-finished hardwood, laminate, and more for less than half what you'll pay somewhere else, and 18-month special financing. Now is the time to warm up your home with new floors, so visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now, no other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com, and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. Advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
Does this ever happen to you? Moments after you're introduced to someone, you forget his or her name. It's a common faux pas you'll want to avoid, especially if you're a job seeker. And even if you're not, here's a tip. As you are being introduced, and while you're still shaking hands, smiling, and making eye contact, say the person's name aloud. Not only does that make a deposit in your memory bank, it acknowledges the other person. And that is more than a nuance, as is maintaining eye contact. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important. Cutting through the clutter rather than blending into the blah, blah, blah will help you connect better, no matter what the conversation. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBucks to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We're talking about the alleged diary of one Ross Ulbricht, the man accused of being the operator of the Silk Road, who we know was the creator of the site, according to the defense's own admission in opening statements. The prosecution claiming they found that the FBI agents found many, many documents on the laptop that Ulbricht was using, which, you know, purportedly would have been an encrypted hard drive, but he was in the middle of using it when they arrested him, is the claim, and so they were able to access all of this information.
I've got a conspiracy theory.
Okay.
So I think that the Silk Road was a false flag. I think the government set up Silk Road, right? And then have, you know, Ross Ulbricht is actually an actor, right? And this is just because they knew that eventually somebody would figure this out, right? So they just wanted to, you know, have an example to make out of somebody, because the fact of the matter is the defense in this case is ridiculous. That you're, I mean, how many years, even if they beat the RICO charge or the Kingpin charge, whatever it is, I mean, he's obviously facing, you know, many decades in prison. Yes. for drugs and money laundering and everything else. And this guy presumably was said that they presumably haven't offered him a deal, right? Because if he's just trying to beat the Kingpin charge, then he couldn't have been offered a deal at any point, right?
Yeah, what it if they seems said, unlikely.
What if they had told him? I mean, basically, the situation, the reason he's at trial right now is simply because they didn't make him a plea offer.
And
it
they can't.
Like.
I mean, he can't right. roll on anybody, right?
Like, that's what happens. So the government will target a small percentage of the cases. The you know, I shouldn't say the government. The people there, the prosecutors, will target a small percentage of those that are charged with the intention of making their careers upon them. We can see the judge acting in this fashion. Mm-hmm. Likely, the prosecutor feels the same way.
A bunch of prosecutors, but yeah.
Yeah, once they get their big break, they prosecute the right guy, they bring him down, then they get some higher position, or they get a judgeship, or they move on to elected office, or whatever it is that they do. But they build their careers based on this. They didn't offer him, I doubt very seriously they offered him a plea. I don't know, I wasn't there, but this is the kind of case they
would.
So
they were basically like, look, you can plead guilty and spend the rest of your life in prison, or go to trial and spend the rest of your life in prison. Mm. And at this point, he's just planning on going to trial and spending the rest of his life in prison. I don't think that you can't confess to. They have to have known that they have this journal, right? The defense knows this. Yep. Before they go to trial, obviously, right? So he knows that they've got everything that he's written down about this in
whatever
his own
is.
Words.
Yep.
And this is going to be brought in front of a jury. So
on the other hand, though, Chris, I mean, the surprise on Thursday last week was the allegations about the MT Gox founder possibly being Dread Pirate Roberts for a time. So maybe the defense has a few tricks up their sleeve. I don't know. There's still several weeks to go in this trial. We're only through witness number two at this point, and there's a dozen of them.
And it certainly makes for a compelling story for him to finger the guy from Mt. Gox, which, on another note, have you been following the Ian Freeman Googling Twitter account?
Every now and then, he says,
the other day you were Googling, did Ross Ulbricht finger Karpeles? And then the next search is, did Ross Ulbricht finger Karpeles sexually?
Ulbricht's defense attorneys, this is from Wired.com, have suggested they'll show that while Ulbricht did in fact create the Silk Road, he gave it up to the administrator who would become the Dread Pirate Roberts. Roberts, they argued to the jury in their opening statement, eventually lured Ulbricht back to serve as the perfect fall guy. The defense has yet to explain how a detailed journal of planning and managing the Silk Road ended up on Ulbricht's computer. In the meantime, however, much of that journal evidence reads like evidence of a massive operational security misjudgment on the part of an overconfident online drug lord. Quote, I imagine someday that I may have a story written about my life, and it would be good to have a detailed account of it. So yeah, he did want a book.
Yeah.
Out of this.
There you go.
The prosecution also cited chat logs found on Ulbricht's
computer. He should have written that book on his computer and then encrypted it with TrueCrypt or whatever, that way they had to brute force break it.
The prosecution.
In this case, they just picked up the box and took it in and, you know, whatever.
The prosecution also cited chat logs found on his computer that seemed to show him communicating with Silk Road staffers, some of which were almost absurdly ironic. Quote, put yourself in the shoes of a prosecutor trying to build a case against you, Prosecutor Howard read aloud at one point, allegedly quoting Ulbricht. Quote, when you look at the chance of us getting caught, it's incredibly small. That's from Wired.com. And then Ars Technica and Business Insider also have some interesting excerpts and information here, jumping a little bit into the Ars article about today's testimony. They saw spreadsheets, the jury did, of Silk Road's finances, Ulbricht's personal tracking of his net worth, and just got a small glimpse of the years of TorChat chat logs with Silk Road administrators that were on the machine. In those chats, myself, the default name for a user of TorChat, made key executive decisions about how to run Silk Road. There were many decisions that had to be made, promotions and demotions, contests and castigations. The jury saw Silk Road organization charts, payroll documents, and daily logs tracking staff activities. They saw Ulbricht's old passport and driver's license, and they saw the scanned IDs, the scanned identifications of Silk Road staffers. Staffers had been promised that those IDs would be kept encrypted, and they were.
But the encryption was broken down by Kiernan, the agent who found the keys on Ulbricht's machine.
Mm.
The computer also contained what appeared to be Ulbricht's personal journal going back to 2010, where he talks about the mushrooms and revealing the secrets, etc. Let's go to Nathan. Nathan's on the line in Texas via Skype. Hello, Nathan.
One second, Nathan. So I can't believe that somebody signed up to go work for the Silk Road and gave this guy their passport. I don't buy it.
Why not?
Because
they wanted the job.
Because it's a conspiracy. Because Ross Ulbricht is a false flag by the United States government in order to take away our civil liberties and shut down the Tor network forever.
Well, they wanted to, prove who they were. They wanted to prove they weren't, cops or whatever or something like that. I guess
that doesn't prove anything. Cops have passports, Ross.
Sure. Nathan, go ahead. Do we have Nathan? Nathan going once. Nathan going twice. All right, maybe there's something wrong with our technical side of things. Apologies about that. Over on the Business Insider story, it says that he admitted in his journal, again, allegedly, that his relationship with his then-girlfriend, this was at the time of the very creation of the site where he was allegedly selling mushrooms, he said his relationship with his then-girlfriend Julia suffered as he tried to keep up with the site's rather unexpected popularity. On more than one occasion, Ulbricht refers to himself as DPR while chatting with Silk Road employees, employees who, incidentally, were hard to find. He wrote, quote, "Working for a criminal enterprise isn't attractive to everyone." He wrote this to one moderator he called Variety Jones in late 2011, according to the chat logs. VJ, according to the journal entries, turned out to be something of a mentor or the devil on Ulbricht's shoulder, depending on how you look at it. Ulbricht said in his journal that he was extremely inexperienced in web hosting when he first launched Silk Road. He knew basic coding and HTML, but often failed to recognize some of the site's early flaws, he wrote. As the first to point out a major security hole in Silk Road, VJ gained Ulbricht's trust early on. One journal entry reveals just how much VJ influenced Ulbricht's perception of Silk Road. Ulbricht allegedly wrote, quote, in December of 2011, "VJ has helped me to see a larger vision, a brand that people come to trust and rally behind. He even envisioned the creation of a Silk Road credit union one day." Ulbricht's experiment soon became his life's work. In his journal, he recalled turning down party invitations and camping trips for fear of being away from the Silk Road for too long.
Mm.
Indeed, his roommates in San Francisco have said they rarely, if ever, saw him out of the house and away from his computer. "I imagine that I someday may have a story written about my life," he says, "so I've been thinking about what's next for me. I don't want to go backwards. I need to find a place I can work from that is off the beaten path." In later chat, Ulbricht speaks with a potential employee who expresses reservations about becoming part of the Silk Road team out of fear of getting caught. Ulbricht assures him that this fear, while unrelenting, is not the worst part about the job. He writes, quote, "The biggest con to this job is having to keep your work a secret," unquote. In opening statements, the defense claimed that he created the Silk Road as an economic experiment and ultimately left the site, as we've explained. So that's some of the latest from the trial today. Lots of documents being revealed from, allegedly, from Ulbricht's laptop. And these are going to be hard for the defense. I mean, what can they say? That the feds made this journal up and planted it there? Or that somehow the other Dread Pirate Roberts planted it there? I mean, it just doesn't make sense.
It would seem to me, and I imagine we'll hear more of it in the future, but if he kept a journal throughout the thing, then there's going to be some entry in that journal that he punched out of the site, right? He's going to say, hey, so on this day, I decided to back out and whatever.
Or he didn't.
Either, one of the two things is going to happen. Either the defense's entire premise is going to be flushed down the toilet and Ross is going to go to prison for the rest of his life, or they're going to find out that, hey, here's the entry where he punched out and here's the entry where he came back in.
I wonder if Ross told his defense attorneys about this diary of his.
Oh, well, they found out during discovery, I'm sure, at the very least.
Let's hope so.
We're out of time tonight. Well, we'll be back tomorrow to continue to follow the Silk Road trial and whatever you want to talk about here on Free Talk Live. Join us online in the meantime at freetalklive.com. Also, ChristopherCantwell.com. Check that out.
I'm a
Free Talk Live.
You guys live in a dream world.
No, sir, you're the one that lives in a dream world. You're the one that wants to have a police state in America where you get to determine who can come in and who can't. You want to have border patrols. You want to have checkpoints.
You want to let the entire third world into this country?
Sir, I'll answer that question by reading a short excerpt from a poem. Maybe you've heard of it. It happens to appear at the bottom of the Statue of Liberty. It was about
your poor, your tired, huddled masses.
Great, you are aware of it, yes.
Let them come in legally.
Well, come on, legally, Lou. The legal is such a cop-out. No, hold on a second, because when your ancestors came across, and I don't know what they are, let's say they're Italian. When your ancestors came across, all they did was take you to Ellis Island, screw up your last name, sit you around for 3 days, and then bam, you're out the door. Now legal is a huge pile of paperwork and tens of thousands of dollars.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Tuesday, January 20th, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,276, silver at $17.69, and Bitcoin is trading around $210. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Your job, your home, your car, your money. All of these provide you with a sense of security. But what about your family's security? What have you done to prepare if all of these things were suddenly gone? eFoods Direct has the food security you need for every emergency. eFoods Direct is food security. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 and mention Liberty Beat for 50% off their food preparation planning packs. In the news, a new report has found that at least 50 U.S. law enforcement agencies are using radar devices that can see through walls into the homes of unsuspecting Americans. The tools have been in use since at least 2012 and have cost $180,000, according to federal contract records. The radars use radio waves to capture movements, such as breathing, from more than 50 feet away. A federal appeals judge in Denver recently stated the government's warrantless use of such a powerful tool to search inside homes poses grave Fourth Amendment questions. The ACLU has labeled President Obama's recent executive order on police militarization as the equivalent of putting a Band-Aid on a war wound. The ACLU's Washington Legislative Office Director, Laura Murphy, stated that the president should consider a moratorium on the Department of Defense's 1033 program until further study and controls are put in place. The 1033 program supplies local police departments and agencies with surplus military equipment and weaponry. Kenyan police fired tear gas at students in Nairobi who are protesting what they say is a theft of their playground. After a 2-week teacher strike, the students found the playground fenced off and sold to a private developer. Riot police attempted to disperse the protest by firing tear gas at the students, teachers, and political activists. Several children were reportedly injured and taken to the hospital. This broadcast of the Liberty Beat is sponsored by WatchMyBit.com, the first ever micropayment-based video service. If you're a content creator, visit WatchMyBit.com to learn how you can use Bitcoin to generate revenue for your art. That's WatchMyBit.com. Support also comes from The Corey Moore Show, comedy-minded, and liberty-focused. Corey and his co-hosts provide unique analysis of the hot topics of the day. Live each Friday night at 10 o'clock Eastern. The Corey Moore Show at CoreyMooreShow.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, January 20th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. The director of the controversial film Grey State has been found dead, along with his wife and daughter, in what is being called an apparent murder-suicide. 29-year-old writer, film producer, and Army veteran David Crowley, his 28-year-old wife, Comel, and their 5-year-old daughter, Rainey, were found dead inside their California home on Saturday. The deaths are currently under investigation. Crowley had been working on the film Grey State, which was a fictional account of a brutal police state and martial law being imposed by a tyrannical government. Seeing everyone connected to the internet is the goal of Google. And that's the apparent reason why the tech company is expected to invest nearly $1 billion in Space Exploration Corporation. The Wall Street Journal, citing people familiar with the talks, reports that Google is interested in Elon Musk's SpaceX because the company plans to use satellites to spread internet service to all corners of the world. Officials for both companies have not yet offered any comment about the deal publicly. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your message or product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more details, go online to thelibertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, January 20th, 2015. Make sure you check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
In studio, we're joined by Ademo Freeman. How you doing, Ademo?
I'm doing great, man. You and I have been hanging out all day, and a day with Derek J is a day in the clouds.
That's right. We got Dio across the inner tubes. How you doing, Dio?
Uncle Dio. I call him Uncle Dio.
What's up, everybody? Uncle Dio, affectionately named by Ademo and the crew at Porkfest.
Hey, and you've got some fancy shirts behind you, Dio. What are those all about?
Yeah, you like that, huh?
Tell me where I can get some.
If I move it out of the way, is the picture frozen?
No, it's not. Yeah, I can see them.
At the CopBlock store on CopBlock.org. We got the iRecord ones, and we got the logo ones, and that's the back of both of them. And we got sweatshirts and sweatpants and stickers and all kinds of junk.
Cool, man. What's the URL one more time?
CopBlock.org/CopBlock store.
I dig it. Now, Ademo, you've been out of the scene for a while. Not everyone knows who you are. Why don't you tell the folks at home your relationship to CopBlock?
Well, in late January of 2010, I founded CopBlock.org and was shortly joined by Pete Ayer, a colleague of mine and good friend that I had done a project previous to that called MotorhomeDiaries.com. as well as Jason Talley. And so the drug war is what brought me to the ideals of liberty. I commonly or frequently refer to myself as a victim of the war on drugs. And after Liberty, or excuse me, after Motorhome Diaries, I, you know, felt I wanted to share my story and my interactions with police, and therefore created copblock.org. And, you know, within 2 weeks of founding the website, Pete had an interaction in Santa Fe, New Mexico, where he was open carrying and filmed the interaction when two police officers approached him and attempted to disarm him and interrogate him for carrying a firearm illegally. And he talked them down and like walked away from them. And it was a really powerful video. I still think it's one of my favorite videos to this day. Because mind you, Pete did this alone. You know, me and him have filmed hundreds of cops together in a manner in which we've called like the A and B roles, and playing off of one another and interchanging those roles.
Good cop, bad cop.
Well, or good filmer, or like a close point of view and a further point of view. But yeah, essentially good cop, bad cop. And so I met up with Pete in Denver, and we were driving out to Wisconsin to stay at my place for a while. And I, before he and I hooked up, I said, hey, let's put this video on CopLock. You know, I've been getting a lot of questions about what other people could do to hold some accountability and, you know, sympathy for my story. You know, maybe we could take this to a different level. And, you know, brainstorming with him, I believe it was even his idea to make it a decentralized organization where people can, you know, share information and ideas and tactics, et cetera. So I guess that's me in a nutshell. I've been a libertarian activist probably since 2009. Libertarian, I guess I would use that loosely.
Yeah, because you're not a political guy, are you?
Well, that would be definitely a small libertarian.